Hi everyone. In our earlier sessions, we have seen how to create a Kubernetes cluster and how to use labels and selectors, all these things. In this session, I'm going to focus on resource limits. Okay, we have to manage resource for containers. We can specify CPU and memory. In this session, we are going to focus more on CPU. For memory, we will do one more video, but this specific session is for managing resource for containers, especially CPU part. Let me show you the cluster which I have. I have a 2-node EKS cluster, which is already up and running. And using these 2-node cluster, I'll try to create pods or deployments, and we'll try to explain the resource limits concept. Okay. First, let us just read the documentation, what it says. Basically, we need to manage resource for containers. Okay. When we are specifying a pod, we can optionally specify how much of each resource a container needs. Okay. We can specify CPU and memory. What happens when we specify these resources is, when we specify the resource request for containers in a pod, the scheduler uses this information to decide which node to place the pod on. In this case, we have 2 nodes. When we specify any CPU information in the resources, it will see which node it has to run the pod on. Okay, this is how we need to define it. Okay, resource request and limits of a pod and container. If you see inside a spec containers, because we can define multiple containers, we have something called resources. Resource limit CPU, resource limits memory, resource request CPU, resource request memory. Okay. Let me show you one quick example and we will see how it works. Okay. We can see this. If you see this pod, we have multiple containers. One container is APP and another container is log aggregator. For APP container, we have specified the resources and requests and limits. Okay. Same way, I created one thing for Nginx. Okay. Let me show you that. This is for memory. That's fine. Okay, let us try to take this. Fine. Let me take this particular example. This is our Nginx pod. Let me explain it here. Okay, this is my Nginx pod. If you see this, I have a container. Container name is Nginx and the image is Nginx. And in the resources, I have mentioned request CPS 0.5 and CPS 1. Okay. Now, what does this mean? What does request means is, to run this pod, we need to allocate 0.5 CPU cores for this pod. If we don't have 0.5 CPU cores, this pod will not be scheduled. Limits is nothing but maximum CPU which is needed by this pod is 1. Okay, request is nothing but we need to provide 0.5 CPU cores for this pod to get scheduled, or else it won't get scheduled. But before doing this, let me show you the capacity of the cluster worker nodes which we have. Okay, we have 2 nodes. I'll show you how many CPU cores are present for each and every node. Just go to root. In root, I have the PEM file. Okay, PEM file is not there. CD labels and selectors. I have the PEM file here. This is my PEM file. Let me see the nodes. Kubectl get nodes. Okay, these are the 2 nodes. If you want to go, you can go to the UI and go to EC2 instances, and you can see the 2 cluster nodes. Okay, these are my 2 cluster nodes. The first cluster node public IP is this. Let me try to connect to the node, worker node 1. SSH hyphen I hello world dot pem ec2 hyphen user at the rate server IP. I'm connecting to the worker node and I'll show you the CPU cores present for this worker node. You can say cat slash proc CPU info pipe grep cores. If you see this, I have one CPU core for the first worker node. And as we created the cluster, even second also will have the same. If you exit from this, and if you see the second one also, let us connect to the second worker node as well. This is the second worker node. Copy this and say ssh hyphen I hello world.pem is my key pair, ec2 hyphen user at the rate of, this is my second worker node. If you see here also, same thing. You can see the CPU cores present for this worker node. Cat slash proc CPU info pipe grep cores. Perfect. It is also having one CPU core. Meaning, as we have two node cluster, we have two CPU cores present. Okay. Overall, we have two CPU cores present. Now, what we are doing is, what is this spell mistake? Kubectl. Now, what we are doing is, out of two CPU cores present, I am saying allocate 0.5 CPU cores for this pod. If we have the space, I mean, if we have the CPU cores available, this pod will run. If you assign more than that, if you assign more than this CPU cores, it will not run. But let me show you the working case. Copy this. It is already there. Let me run this. Kubectl nginx hyphen pod. Kubectl apply or create. Kubectl apply hyphen f nginx pod. If you see now, kubectl get pods hyphen o void. If you see, pod is up and running. Okay. Why? Because we have two worker nodes, and those two worker nodes has one CPU core each, and out of that we are requesting only 0.5 cores for the pod. Okay. This is working case. Okay. Now what I will do is, if you want, you can say kubectl top pod. Pod name is this. Okay, now let me do one thing. I'll install metric server and then we will see this. Okay, just say install metric server Kubernetes. Click on installing metric server. Copy this and just execute this command. This will install metric server deployment. And if you want, you can cross check this, which is in the kube system namespace. Perfect. Now metric server is up and running, but let me do one thing. Kubectl get pods hyphen o void, and then kubectl top pod. Pod name is nginx. Perfect. Now if you see, it is having only 5M, right? 5M. Okay, it is not using more than that. Now what I will do is, I will delete the pod and I will change the CPU cores to a higher number, and then we will see our pod won't get scheduled. Perfect. Now what we can do is vi nginx hyphen pod. Inside this, in the resources section, you can mention, if you don't want to mention like this, right, you can mention 2000 mi, right? You can mention like this, 50 m, not this one. You can mention like this, 2000 m. Here you can say like 3000 m. When you say 2000 m, how it calculates is, here m, the unit m represents thousands of the core. Okay, it should be small m. I given wrong. CPU should be small m. Okay, memory should be capital M, CPU should be small m. You can give like this also. Now what does this represent is thousands of the core. 2000 divided by 1000 will give you two cores. Okay, we have only two nodes, two cores, but there were other processes running which will take some CPUs, right? Now in this case the pod will not get scheduled. Now you will see kubectl apply hyphen -f nginx hyphen pod. Now see this kubectl get pods hyphen o wait. Now see, it's in pending, it will never come to running state. If you want to see kubectl describe pod, pod name is nginx, sorry, command is wrong, kubectl. Now see this, sorry, describe pod nginx. Now see what it is saying, it is expecting two CPU cores and it's not able to find the CPUs. That's why it is saying 0/2 nodes are available, two insufficient in CPUs. It is not able to allocate two CPUs for this pod. That's why it failed scheduling. Okay, and I showed you earlier there were two worker nodes. Each worker node has two CPU cores, including both. Each one has one CPU core. Total together it has two CPU cores. But there were other processes which were running. If you see kubectl get pods hyphen hyphen all hyphen namespaces, these pods are taking couple of CPUs, right? Like CPU cores they are like consuming. That's why the nginx is still in pending, because it is expecting two CPU cores, but there were other processes which were running. That's why it was not able to allocate two CPU cores for this. Let us delete the deployment, and again if we change it to a lower number it will work. Kubectl apply hyphen f, sorry, let me delete the pod first. Kubectl delete pod nginx. Perfect. Now vi nginx hyphen pod, here mention some lower number, something like 500. 500 is fine. Okay, 500 by 1000 will be around, you can say 500 by 1000, it will come very small number. Okay, and here you can say 1000, something like this. Okay, save this. Now if you run kubectl apply command, it will schedule the pod. Now kubectl apply hyphen f nginx pod. Perfect. Now see kubectl get pods hyphen o wait. Now it's running, right? Up and running. If you describe, it shows it. Kubectl describe pod nginx. Now see, sorry, perfect. Now see, it is saying successfully assigned default nginx to this worker node. Container image already present on the image. Created container, started container. That means this pod got scheduled perfectly. Now I hope this, whatever we have seen, these two parameters are clear. Like we have seen how to add the resources into the pod and how the resources are coming into picture. How request is coming into picture, limits is coming into picture. For request, whatever CPU you are mentioning, definitely that CPU core should be available on the worker nodes, or else the pod will not get scheduled. In case of limits, this is like maximum limit. Once it reaches this, your pod gets terminated automatically. Okay, we have seen this one and this one clearly. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel.